Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to discuss about App Exchange that is available in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and follow my YouTube channel. So let's first understand about some theoretical points related to App Exchange. So first, let's discuss introduction of App Exchange. So here, 3 points are listed. So I'm going through with first point. So first point says App Exchange is an online marketplace for Salesforce apps, components, and consulting services, right? So you can find out these three things, apps, components, and consulting services on App Exchange. Second point says developers or consultants can use it as a gateway for connecting with customers to provide their business solutions. So this point is related to developers or consultants, how they can use App Exchange. Then third point says Salesforce admins or users can find tools to improve their company's productivity. So this is brief introduction about App Exchange. Now I'm moving to second point, that is how does App Exchange works? So it contains 4 sub points. So first point says primary marketing tool for promoting apps or components. So App Exchange promotes various applications or components that are built in Salesforce. In listing, one can describe solution, pricing, support, and other details. So while listing any application or component, you can describe these 4 things. Then third sub point says can also upload videos, white papers, and other content to help customers understand the app or component. And last point says App Exchange categorizes the listing into various business areas like sales, marketing, or analytics. So this is the way how App Exchange works. So you can list your component or applications on App Exchange so that anyone can buy that by paying certain amount. So I hope you understood how App Exchange work. This is a brief idea about that. Further, I'm going to tell who can use App Exchange. So there are 4 sub points. So anyone can browse listings and test apps or components. Second point says need download packages permissions to install app or components. Next point says to create a package and upload it to partner community, one must have create packages and upload packages permissions, right? Last point says to create and publish a listing, one must have the manage listing permission. So this way, I hope you understood who can use App Exchange. So we need a different kind of permissions while working with App Exchange. So now let me go to my org so that I can demo you how we can reach out to App Exchange. So if we click on this app launcher, so at top right corner, you can see there's a button, visit App Exchange. So click on that button. So it will open up App Exchange. So it is opening homepage. So here you can see various apps, then various components. So first it is showing apps, then it is showing components, and then it is showing consultants. So all 3 options are available here. If you click on more, so it will open up all available apps, components, and consultants. Now, if you want to go with a particular category, so you can see all 3 options are available. If you click on apps, so it will open up all available applications. So you can scroll down and you can visit this to view all available apps. So it is also saying like it is lightning ready, marketing cloud. So these captions are saying the details also. Then if I click on this link, so it says popular apps, new apps, free apps, collections, categories. So this way you can select a particular option from here also. So it is showing 3, 6, 4, 6 apps. Then if we click on components, So here you can see Lightning components for Community Cloud. Then if we scroll down, so here it is saying so you need to scroll down so that you can view various components. So for some components, it is showing one category also. So you can find out that while you will be using this. Then we have third option, consultants. So it will show all available consultants. So here you can see all consultants. So 1462 consultants are available. You can scroll down and you can search them. You can also directly search AppExchange from here. So you can do that. Now at right hand side, you have this filter option. So you can filter this AppExchange on various parameters. Then we have this option which sort by popularity rating and certified experts. So this way you can use this filter and sorting. Then here you can see AppExchange website link is available. So I'm clicking on that. So it is opening appexchange.salesforce.com. So here you can see various options are available, recommended for you, solutions by type, product collection, industry collection, consultants, Ohana. So various things are available here. So you can choose the option as per your requirement. Then from here you can search, like I want to search Lightning components. So I typed Lightning components and entered. So it will search Lightning components keyword. So here you can see various apps are available. Then bold solution, components, consultants, contained. So these sections are available, flow solution, Lightning data. So these all are related to Lightning components. At left hand side, you can see various filters are available. So you can use these filters to minimize the data which is displayed here. Language option is also there. So this way you can use this AppExchange website so that you can find out apps, components, or consultants. Right, so I hope you understood how we can explore AppExchange. So now I am again clicking on a particular app. Like if I click on this app, so it will open up. So here you can see at left hand side, its details are available. It is free to use. Then at right hand side, its description is available. If you scroll down, so more description is available. Related tabs, customer also installed, security terms, right? So these things are available. If you click on get it now, so it is asking these things to continue, log into your AppExchange account. If you don't have an AppExchange account, use your Salesforce credential instead. Disable your browser's pop-up blocker before you log in. So this way you can log in and download apps from AppExchange. So I hope you understood more about AppExchange with this demonstration. So first I explained theoretical aspects of AppExchange, then I demonstrated how you can get AppExchange, or you can download apps components from AppExchange, and you can search for the consultants that are available on this website. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube, and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.